Hi, I'm Dr. Swarchala, Scientific Director with Ziva Fertility Centers. In IVF or in vitro fertilization, trigger injections play a very crucial role in preparing the eggs for retrieval. These injections are typically given towards the end of the ovarian stimulation phase and after the follicles, which are fluid-filled sacs containing eggs, have developed to the appropriate size. Let's try to understand the role and function. It helps in final maturation of eggs. The main purpose of trigger injection is to induce the final maturation of oocytes. Follicles develop through the stimulation process, but the eggs inside them are not fully mature. Trigger injections stimulate the last stage of egg maturation, making them capable for fertilization. Ovulation timing is also very critical. In a natural cycle, a surge in luteinizing hormone from the pituitary gland causes ovulation. Ovulation is the release of a mature egg from the ovary. In an IVF cycle, trigger injections mimic this natural LH surge. They ensure that ovulation happens at a predictable time, allowing the fertility specialist to schedule the egg removal process exactly, typically which is 34 to 36 hours after the trigger. It also helps in preventing premature ovulation. In IVF, it's critical to control when ovulation occurs. Without a trigger injection, premature ovulation might occur and the eggs would be released from the ovaries before they can be retrieved, which is a total loss of your cycle. So triggers are very important. What are the types of trigger injections? Human chorionic gonadotropin is a very commonly used trigger. Historically, HCG has been used as a trigger injection because it closely mimics luteinizing hormone and can stimulate the final maturation of eggs. However, it carries a higher risk of ovarian hyperstimulation syndrome, especially in women who have developed many follicles. Then there is gonadotropin releasing hormone agonist. This type of trigger injection is often used in cases where the patient is at a risk of OHSS, ovarian hyperstimulation syndrome. GnRH agonists stimulate the pituitary gland to release a surge of LH and FSH, follicle stimulating hormone, which causes oocyte maturation, egg maturation definitely, but it reduces the risk of OHSS. Then we also have dual trigger, where a combination of HCG and GnRH agonist is given. In some cases, a combination of HCG and GnRH agonist is used to improve not only the egg quality, but also the retrieval outcomes, especially for patients with poor ovarian reserves or a poor response or suboptimal prior IVF cycles. These are the kind of triggers given. What are the considerations? Egg quality is very important. The timing and type of trigger injection can affect the quality and maturity of the eggs, which in turn influences, of course, the fertilization rate, embryo development, and pregnancy outcomes. We also have to look at OHSS risk. Managing the dosage and timing of trigger is very critical to minimize the risk of ovarian hyperstimulation syndrome, which is a serious complication. The decision on which type of trigger injection to use depends on individual patient factors, including ovarian response, number of follicles, and the risk of OHSS. So these are the reasons why trigger injections are given. If you wish to understand more about this or IVF procedure, please feel free to contact us. Thank you. A lot of effort has gone into making this video. Please like and subscribe us. Thank you.